Good afternoon, friends. We will discuss today finite element analysis, and in that we will discuss direct applications of element matrix equation. So you know, friends, this we will talk about stress analysis. So stress analysis, we will calculate the stresses in stresses and load application. For applying so and so load, how many stresses are developed in the bar? So consider this as your domain. In this domain, you can see there are three different parts of different lengths. First is 100 mm, second is 50 mm, and the third one is 100 mm again. So you will call this as elements. Okay, so this first, second and third of various length are known as elements, and the nodes, that is the end point of or starting point of every element, will be known as nodes. So in this figure you can see that there are four nodes and three elements. Node number 1 is fixed support here. Node number 2 is the joining of first and second element, and node number 3 is joining of second and third element, and last is the end point of the third element, that is again joined as with the fixed support. Okay, the element is the part in between node 1 and 2, the second element is the part in between node 2 and 3, and the third element is the part in between node number 3 and 4. So we can see here elements number is 3 and nodes are 4. So what is this? How you can say that this is the element number 2? This phenomenon is called as discretization. Discretization is nothing but dividing the domain into number of elements or identification of nodes. From this discretization, you can identify the nodes and divide the elements. So you can see that there are three rules of discretization. The rule number 1 is change of shape. Whenever there is shape change or length change, that means you can say that the element will change. So here we can see that this is, suppose, my element 1 of length 100 mm, and this here the shape is changing to 50 mm, and the area A1 is given as 100 mm square, and area 2 we can say as 50 mm square. So we can say that there is a change of shape, so our element will change. So this is one rule of discretization. First rule of discretization is change in shape. The second rule is, suppose this is my element having some load attached of force P as is equal to 5 kilo Newton. The length is 100 mm. So I say some area A1, and the load is attached as 5 kilo Newton. Whenever there is application of load, you can say that area is changing, or otherwise I can add here some other area, some other element having some area, and here this is P is equal to 5 kilo Newton, area A2, length is 50 mm. So after this I have applied some force P. So the change in application of load, that means at this point your element will change. So you have two elements with the application of force. Again, if I have, instead of application of force here, if I am drawing my force P application is here, P kilonewton. Then my area element will change into one, this will be second and this will become as third. So my application will be first application element, second, third element. Okay. Third is change in material. Suppose I will take the same diagram and application of force P kilonewton. Suppose this material is steel, this element is of aluminium and this is brass. Whenever there is change in material, the element will change. So this will be element number 1, element number 2, element number 3. Again, suppose I have applied here some element brass, so again my element will change here. This will become second, third and fourth. If I apply force of P kilonewton, again here my element number will change. So this will become as 4, this will become as 5. This element, we are dividing the element because there is application of load. So the second rule with the third rule, it is defining the number of element again. Okay, so you understood how, what are the rules of discretization. The number one is change in shape, the second is load application and change in material. So this, based on this you will solve the problems: shape change, application of load and material change. Okay, so we'll solve problems based on step bar. Analysis of step bar. We'll take this diagram. The diameter given as 40 diameter 15 and diameter 30 mm. The force is applied, P is equal to 15 kilonewton. The length is given as 200 mm.500 mm and 200 mm. Okay. The value of modulus of elasticity is given as 200 × 10³ newton per mm square. So this is our given sum and we have to analyze the step bar. So what you will calculate? You will calculate values of P and stress in this sum. So what we will do now? This will be, we will divide the elements number now. That means discretization we will do. The first step will be divide the elements. Elements and nodes. That is your step number 1. So we can say that this will be my node number 1, node number 2, node number 3, and node number 4. So there are 4 nodes and elements. The area length of this is 200 mm, having diameter 40 mm. So this will be my for element number 1. In next element, the length is 500 mm and diameter 15 mm. So that is element number 2, and the last one is having length 200 mm with diameter 30 mm. So this is my element number 3. So there are 3 element and 4 nodes. Understood? So we will divide now. I'll write here E is 200 into 10 raised to 3 Newton per mm square. So now we'll divide, separate out this element one by one. So this is element number 1, having diameter as diameter 40 and length is 200 mm. So this is my element number 1. I have separated out this here. Okay. So we will calculate first area of this entity, and that is pi by 4 into d square. Okay. The area comes out to be 1256.64 mm square. The area is 1256.64, and length, that is denoted by h for element 1, we can say this is h1 as 200 mm. Similarly, we will calculate all the areas for every element. The second element is diameter 15 and length is 500 mm. So area will be pi by 4 into 15 square, that comes out to be 176.7 mm square, and h2 is 500 mm. Similarly, for element number 3, the diameter is given as 30 mm and the length is 200 mm. The area will be pi by 4, 30 square. Okay, the area comes out to be 706.86 mm square, and h3 will be 200 mm. Clear? So we have calculated area for every element. Now for first element, we will calculate the stiffness matrix AE by HE, that is stiffness constant for matrix number element number 1. So AE by H1, that will give you area for first element is 1256.64 into E is same, because the material is same. So E value, modulus of elasticity, will be same, into 10 raised to 3 divided by H is 200. Okay. Similarly, for second element, A2 I can say upon H2 is equal to, the area for second element is 176.7 into 200 into 10 raised to 3 divided by 500, that will be my second element. And for third element, A3 up into E upon H3, that is 706.86 into 200 into 10 raised to 3 divided by 200. So I got the values as A E upon H E for first is 1256.64 into 10 raised to 3 Newton per mm. Okay. For second one, I got the value as 70.68 into 10 raised to 3 Newton per mm. And for third one, 706.86 into 10 raised to 3 Newton per mm. Okay. Clear up to this? Again, okay. So we will rub this. Now we will calculate element matrix equation. For every element, we will try to solve this in terms of matrix. So, the steepness matrix will be calculated as AE by H E 1 minus 1 minus 1 1 U 1 U 2 equal to P 1 P 2. So, what is this U 1 and U 2? When you apply force of 15 kilo Newton here, what will be the displacement at this point? So, displacement at first node will be U 1, at second node it will be U 2, third node it will be U 3, and fourth node will be U 4. So, we need to calculate displacement and forces from element matrix equation. We will consider this for first element. We already have the AE by H value for first element as 1256.64 into 10 raised to 3, the matrix 1 minus 1 minus 1 1. We will take U 1 and U 2 and for force P 1 and P 2. Why we have taken U 1 and U 2 and P 1 and P 2? Because our element number 1 lies in between the node 1 and 2. When we will calculate element matrix equation for second, we will consider U 2 and U 3, because the second element lies between node number 2 and node number 3. Similarly, the third element lies between node number 3 and node number 4. So, first element matrix equation, I got this. I will solve this as 10 raised to 3, I have taken out. Substitute this 1256.64 into matrix, you will get positive 1256.64, negative. Similarly, here minus 1256.64 plus 1256.64. Rest will be same, U 1, U 2 equal to P 1, P 2. Okay. Note this matrix now as number 1, 2, 1, 2. Let it be in this form itself. Now, we will calculate for element number 2. What will be AE by HE matrix equation? The value of AE by HE is 70.68 into 10 raised to 3. The same equation I am using here to substitute the value here, 1 minus 1 minus 1 1. Now for element number 2, I will take 2 and 3. So, my displacement will become U2 and U3, similarly here P2 and P3. Clear? So again we will substitute 10 raised to 3, we will take out and substitute the value 70.68 into matrix. So we will get the matrix as plus 70.68 minus 70.68. Again second row is minus 70.68, positive 70.68. Rest will be same, U2, U3 equal to P2, P3. Clear? Next, similarly, again here also note this as 2, 3, 2, 3. Make this habit of noting element matrix equation with the respective nodes. Similarly, I will write directly my third element matrix equation as 7, 0, 6. I will directly write this matrix at 10 raised to 3, I have taken out 706.68 minus 706.68 minus 706.68 positive 706.68. U3, U4, because element number 3 is in between the nodes U3 and 4, and rest will be P3 and P4. Okay, mark this as third, fourth. Clear up to this? So we got this element matrix equation for no element number 1, element number 2 and element number 3. We have marked from the nodal analysis also, nodal points also we have specified the matrix. Okay. Now we will assemble this element matrix equation in global matrix equation. I will rub this diagram. Now my global matrix equation is nothing but I will assemble complete matrix. I have taken 10 raised to 3 common. This is my global. Global matrix. Global matrix equation. Note here 1, 2, 3. Okay. Similarly, here also I will assemble. So I will get this term as U1, U2, U3 is equal to P1, P2, P3. Now here my 1, 1, I have marked 1, 2, 3 in rows and 1, 2, 3 in column. I have to just put this matrix and substitute it here. Okay, sorry. Forgot right here P3 and P4. I am sorry for that. P4, U3, U4. One, two, three, four. Because we have 4 nodes. So my first equation will be, I will take this point 1, 1, first row, first column value, I will write directly as it is 1256.64. Second column, first row, it is minus 1256.64. Now, in the first row, there are no third and fourth column. So, I will directly write 0, or you can keep it as it is and later you can fill this row. Now, second, my first row is completed. Now, I will go to second row. The second row is having second row first column as minus 1256.64 and plus 1256.64. So here you have completely written your matrix number 1. So come back to matrix number 2, element matrix number 2 equation. Here you can see this is for node element number 2. So you can see this value is already you have written here, but there is one more value in second element matrix. So the sign, as the sign is positive, you will add this as 70.68. Understood? Just you have to add it to fill the matrix. And the second row and third column is -70.68. Again, in this matrix there is no fourth column, so mark it as 0. Okay, so you can see the triangle is made up here. Okay, third. Now third row, second row is completed, now third. Third row you will see as the third column, row, second column. So there is no first column here, so mark it as 0. Third row, second column is -70.68. Third row, third column, +70.68. Okay. Now third element matrix is here. Third row and fourth column we have some value as -706.68 in the third element matrix. 3 again here, 3 it's +706.68. Okay, fourth row, third row is also completed. Fourth row there is directly third column, so we'll mark first and two second column as 00 and third column will be -706.68. Fourth row, fourth column is +706.68. So this will be your global matrix. Global matrix equation you will get in this form. And as we have seen, the our no force P is P4 at node 4 is given as 15 kilonewton. So we can take this 15 into 10 raised to 3. So this 10 raised to 3 and this 10 raised to 3 cancels out, and you will get the global matrix equation in this format. So I will write properly here global matrix equation 1256.64 -1256.64 0 -1256.64. The addition of 1256.64 plus 70.68 comes out to be 1327.32 -70.68 0. Again here 0 -70.68. This addition 706 plus 70.68 is 777.54 and -706.68, and the last row is 00 -706.68 positive 706.68. Rest will be same U1, U2, U3, U4 is equal to P1, P2, P3 and P4 is given as 15. Okay, this is my global matrix equation. Now, in our sum, we can see that at first node, there is fixed support given. So when we'll try to apply some force, the displacement at node number 1 will be 0. When we apply P equal to 15 kilo Newton, the displacement as U1 will be 0 because this is fixed support. So according to, there is one statement, according to Gauss elimination law, Gauss elimination method, or you can say Gauss elimination law, when U1 is equal to 0, the first row and first column will get eliminated. According to Gauss elimination law, when U1 is 0, first row and first column will get eliminated. So here U1 will become 0. Solve this in terms of matrix, so we'll get the equation in terms of write the equation 1256.64 U1 minus 1256.64 U2 is equal to P1. If the second, solve the matrix, because U3 and U4 term are 0, I have not written it here. The second equation can be equation number 1. Second equation will become as minus 1256.64 U1 plus 1327.32 U2 minus 70.68 U3 is equal to P2. This will be your equation number 2. Let it be U1. Minus 7 0 6 point 68 U4 plus 7 0 6 point 68 U3 plus 7 0 6 point 68 U4 plus 7 0 6 point 68 U3 plus 7 0 6 point 68 U4 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 plus 1193. So from this we'll calculate sigma 1, we'll get as the answer will be 11.93 newton per mm square. We have just solved the matrix, nothing else. Similarly, sigma 2 will get as 200 into 10 raised to 3 divided by 500. The element length for second element is 500. Rest is same matrix minus 1 1. Here it will become U2 and U3, because this we are calculating for element number 2. So we have U2 value as 200 into 10 raised to 3 divided by 500 minus 1 1. U2 is 0.01193 and U3 is 0.224. So this will give you value of sigma as 84.83 newton per mm square. Similarly, sigma 3 will be 200 into 10 raised to 3, that is your E, divided by 200, element length for third element minus 1 1 U3, and to change this as per the note. So U3 is nothing but I can directly write here 0.224, and U4 I can directly write as 0.245.